Hello friends, welcome back to this session. So in the last video we have seen the exercise 5.4 and we have solved the first six questions in detail. So if you have not seen those video, please go through that and come back to this video. In this video we will be covering the remaining six questions from the exercise same 5.4. So let's start with the question number 7. It says that using a vector method, we have to prove something. Using vector method, prove that a quadrilateral is a rhombus. If and only if IFF diagonals bisect each other at right angle. Okay. So please do not get confused between the rhombus and the parallelogram which we have seen in the last question. So in the parallelogram also the diagonals bisect each other. In rhombus also we have the same case, but the difference is what? In the parallelogram we do not have right angled bisection, but here in this case we have the right angled bisection. So let me draw a figure so it will be clear. Rhombus is nothing but a square, tilted square you can say. So it's a tilted square where all the sides are same. Okay, let's name this as a OA, this is a B and it's a C. So let's mark the vectors. Okay, let's have the diagonals, both the diagonals. So it's a OC and it's an AB. Okay, this is an origin of course. So let's have the vectors now. So let's name as it is a A bar. This is a B bar. If it is A bar, this will also become A bar and this will become the B bar. Okay, so with the help of the triangle law, can you give me what is the OC bar? So OC bar is nothing but what? It is A bar plus B bar. So this becomes A bar plus B bar. OC bar becomes A bar plus B bar. And what about this AB bar? What about AB bar? So AB bar is nothing but you can go in this way, in this direction or in this direction. So AB bar means what? It is a B bar and it should be the negative. That is a AC bar plus CB bar. Okay. CB bar is nothing but minus of A bar. So let's write down in that way. So it is a B bar minus A bar here. This is nothing but the AB bar. Okay. So let me write here from figure. Okay, so A bar, B bar are the position vectors of point A and B. Using triangle law, yes, OC bar is equals to what? It is a OA bar plus AC bar, which is nothing but A bar plus B bar. OC bar is nothing but, so equation number 1, and the AB bar is equals to, it is AC bar plus CB bar. Okay, so which is nothing but AC bar is B bar and CB bar is minus A bar. So this is equals to equation number 2. Now what we have to show that is there is a bisection. See, the rhombus, this is a rhombus, we have directly considered as OABC is a rhombus, and we have to now show that these two diagonals, that is OC and AB, bisect each other. bisect means what? This point is a common and this should be the midpoint of both. Okay, and we have to show that there is a 90 degree angle between these two. So what two points we need to show here is, so first point is what? Diagonals bisect this first part, and the second part is the angle between the two diagonals, that is AB and OC, is equals to 90 degree. Okay, these two parts we have to show. Now for the angle bisection, what we can do is, okay, first let me have the position vectors of all these vectors. So it is A bar, here we have A bar plus B bar, and here we have the B bar, and this is of course the vector origin. So let's have the midpoints of the both the diagonals. Okay, so find out the midpoints of the both diagonals. So midpoint of, let's say OC, midpoint of OC bar is nothing but O bar plus C bar divided by 2. So O bar is nothing but it is 0, so it is 0, 0i, 0j, 0k, 0 vector plus A bar plus B bar divided by 2. So what you are getting, it is A bar plus B bar by 2. This is nothing but the midpoint, and let's name that is equals to M bar. Let's name this point is equals to M bar. Okay, so A bar plus B bar by 2 is the position vector of the midpoint of the segment OC, equation number 3. And let's find out the midpoint of the vector AB bar. Okay, so it is nothing but A bar plus B bar, A bar plus B bar by 2. See, this is the equation number 4 we are getting. So from the equation number 3 and 4, what you can see, by dono ka jo midpoint hai na, wo same hi position vector, means what, we have the same point. So we can definitely say from the equation number 3 and 4, from 3 and 4, the M bar is equals to A bar plus B bar by 2 is the common midpoint. Okay, so from that, therefore what we can say, the diagonals are bisecting each other. Diagonals are bisecting each other. Bisecting each other. Now how you will show that this bisection is a right angle triangle, sorry, right angle? So definitely if you want to show the 90 degree, means what, there has to be dot product equals to 0. Okay, so the dot product kiska lo gaya, AB ka and OC ka. So let's now have the dot product of OB bar and AB bar and OC bar. Let's check. Now AB bar dot OC bar, it is equals to what? So OB, AB bar is nothing but B bar minus A bar, and OC bar is nothing but A bar plus B bar. Yes or no? A bar plus B bar. So let's open this dot. So it is B bar dot A bar plus B bar dot B bar minus A bar dot A bar and minus A bar dot B bar. So this is equals to, okay, so what can be cancelled out? So AB bar cancel. So remaining is what, it is a B bar dot B bar is B square minus A bar dot A bar is A square. And I already told you that this is the rhombus, and that is a tilted square. Means what? We have the mod of A bar is equals to mod of B bar. Means implies A is equals to B. Okay, the sides are same. So definitely if that is the case, therefore this is equals to 0. Okay, so if that is the case, then this is directly equals to 0. And as the dot product is equals to 0, we can say the angle between AB bar and OC bar is equals to 90 degree. Is this okay? So I hope you are getting this. So in this way, we have proved that the rhombus diagonals bisect each other at a 90 degree. Perfect. Let's see the next question, 8th. So let me have some space here. Okay, okay, the question number 8. Using a vector method, yes, sabhi vector method se hi karna hai aapko. Using vector method, Okay, what you have to do now? Show that the segments joining the midpoints. Show that the segments joining the midpoints of the consecutive sides of a quadrilateral form of a parallelogram. Okay, so क्या बोला है? Using a vector method show that the segments joining the midpoints of the consecutive sides of the quadrilateral form of नहीं चाहिए यहाँ पे of form a parallelogram. Okay, let's draw a figure so that it will be clear what it is saying. So let me have any one quadrilateral, any random quadrilateral I will draw here. So let's take this as a quadrilateral. Okay, it is some sort of quadrilateral we are having. Let's name this quadrilateral as ABCD. ABCD. And क्या बोला है यहाँ पे? Show that the segments joining the midpoints of the consecutive sides of the parallelogram. So let's have the midpoints now. So इसका midpoint ये रहेगा, इसका midpoint ये, इसका ये रहेगा, okay, and इसका ये रहेगा. Now we are joining these midpoints. So what you will get is a form of parallelogram. Form of चाहिए आपको, ठीक है? So form of a parallelogram. So let's name this as a P, Q, R and S. Q, R and S. So if it is parallelogram, that what we have to show. The two opposite sides are same. Okay, so that we have to prove that this PQ bar is equals to SR bar, and PS SP bar is equals to RQ bar. This if you are able to show, then we say that this PQRS is a parallelogram and they are parallel to each other. Means opposite side should be parallel and they should be of same length. Okay, means magnitude bhi chahiye or direction bhi chahiye. Means what you can prove simply is, that is proof kya karna hai aapko ki PQ bar is same as the SR bar and SP bar is same as the RQ bar. If you are showing this, then that is sufficient. Means it shows that the magnitude of PQ and SR, vector direction of PQ and SR are same. Then we can say that this PQRS is the parallelogram. Okay, so what to do now? Thumb rule says that whenever we have the midpoints, just to first find out the position vectors of those points. Okay, so let's find out P bar. P bar is nothing but the midpoint of AB bar. So it is A bar plus B bar by 2. Then you have Q bar, which is equals to midpoint of BC bar. So it is B bar plus C bar by 2. Then we have R bar, which is nothing but the midpoint of C bar and D bar. So C bar plus D bar by 2. And S bar is equals to A bar plus D bar by 2. Okay. Now let's find out the PQ bar. What is PQ bar? PQ bar is nothing but, okay, let me change the color. So it is nothing but Q bar minus P bar. So let's substitute P bar and Q bar values. So Q bar is nothing but B bar plus C bar by 2 minus P bar is nothing but A bar plus B bar by 2. Okay, so if I take 2 common, so what is remaining is B bar plus C bar minus A bar minus B bar. So minus B bar plus B bar cancel, so it is equals to 1 by 2 into C bar minus A bar, which is nothing but 1 by 2 AC bar. Is this okay? This is nothing but the 1 by 2 AC bar. So what is AC bar is? This part is a AC bar. Sorry. This part is an AC bar. So here, if you observe very carefully, you have express this PQ bar as the scalar multiple of AC bar. Means what? This PQ is parallel to AC. Yes or no? So as PQ bar is a scalar multiple of AC bar, here PQ bar is parallel to AC bar, because the theorem number 1 says that if you express the any two vectors as a scalar multiple, then those two vectors are collinear vectors. Okay, so this is all about the PQ bar. So let's name this equation number 1. And now let's have PQ bar ke saath mujhe SR bar chahiye. So let's find out the SR bar. So SR bar is equals to SR bar is equals to R bar minus S bar, which is nothing but what is R bar is? It is C plus D and S is A plus D. So R bar is C plus D. C bar plus D bar by 2 minus it is S is nothing but A bar plus D bar by 2, A bar plus D bar by 2. So if you open this, I will take 1 by 2 common. What is remaining is C bar plus D bar minus A bar minus D bar. What is remaining then there? So this minus D plus D cancel. So 1 by 2 again, you are getting C bar minus A bar, which is nothing but 1 by 2 AC bar. Okay, again you have expressed this SR bar as the scalar multiple of AC bar. So what you can say is SR bar is parallel to AC bar. See, this PQ bar and SR bar are parallel to the same vector AC bar. So can I say from the equation number 2 and 3, from 2 and 3, sorry, 2 and 3, from 1 and 2, the PQ and SR are parallel to AC bar, therefore PQ bar and SR bar are parallel. PQ bar and SR bar are also parallel. Also, PQ bar is equals to SR bar is equals to 1 by 2 AC bar. Means what? These two vectors are same. Means what? Their direction as well as their magnitudes are same. Okay, so in this way we can prove that the any two opposite sides are same. So similarly you can prove for this SP bar and RQ bar. Okay, so after that what you will conclude is that these opposite sides of the these consecutive sides of the midpoints, so this PQ and SR, SP and RQ are same. That's why the given statement, that is the consecutive sides of the midpoints, is satisfied as opposite. Okay, so before that we can prove that similarly we can easily prove that so this becomes PQ and SR again. So next is what? It is SP and RQ. So SP bar and RQ bar are same. Okay, therefore as opposite sides are same, given statement is proved. Perfect, very good, excellent. Okay, so I hope you are getting this. You all are with me. Okay, if you have not understood, please watch this video once again so that it will be very clear to you. Let's directly jump to the next question, question number 9. So here we go. See, the same thing I am telling you again and again, that this part of the vector requires some patience and have the basic knowledge of vectors as well as the geometry. So what is a quadrilateral, what is a parallelogram, what is a rhombus, what about their diagonals, what are the different conditions we have. So all these things we should know. Okay, see the next question. So in the next question we require the concept of this square and rectangle. Let's see. If the diagonals of a parallelogram, are of equivalence, then prove that then prove that the parallelogram is a rectangle. Then prove that the parallelogram is a rectangle. Okay, then we have to prove that the parallelogram is a rectangle. So let me have a figure here so that it will be very clear. So prove क्या करना है, rectangle prove करना है ना, parallelogram. So let's directly draw the rectangle here. So I hope you remember the properties or the concept of this rectangle. All the sides are at 90 degree. Okay, sorry, all the angles are at 90 degree and the opposite sides are of same length. And here we have this ABCD rectangle, ABCD, and we have the two diagonals here. One is AC and other is the BD. Okay, so what the statement says is that these, if the diagonals of parallelogram are equal, so this is what some parallelogram I have taken. Parallelogram means what I told you, opposite side should be same and they are of the same length. देखो यहाँ पे AD and BC are the opposite sides and they are same. AD, AB and DC are also opposite sides and they are same. So this becomes a parallelogram. Okay. Now the diagonals, this is AC and DB are of equal lengths. उन्होंने दिया है. What they have given is AC mod AC is equals to mod of DB. They have given. These are the what? Diagonals of the parallelogram. Then we have to prove that this parallelogram is a rectangle. Means what? We have to show that the angle between the two, any angle is of 90 degree. So what we can show is simply that you take this AD bar and AB bar, their dot product should also be equals to 0. Okay, so let's name these vectors first. Let's name this as P bar. This is Q bar. If it is P bar, this becomes P bar. If it is Q bar, this becomes Q bar. Okay, now what information they have given is AC bar is equals to BD bar. So AC bar, kahan pe hai AC bar? This is what we have, the AC bar. So AC bar kya ho gaya? Using this parallelogram law, triangle law, AB bar plus AC bar, ye ho gaya P bar plus Q bar. And what about the BD bar? BD bar, you take BD bar or DB bar, no problem. So let's, here I have written this DB bar. So let's write down with the DB bar. So DB bar becomes what? It is P bar minus Q bar. So it will be P bar minus Q bar. Okay. So let me draw here. From figure. What is AC bar? AC bar is equals to AB bar plus BC bar, which is nothing but P bar plus Q bar. And this DB bar is equals to DC bar plus CB bar, which is equals to P bar plus minus Q bar, which is nothing but P bar minus Q bar. Okay. Now you have these two vectors, AC bar and DB bar. So use the just given condition, that is mod of AC and mod of DB are same. Or you can say their directions are also same. Okay, देखो ना यार, AC and DB. Okay, not direction, their lengths are same. So let's use this given information and let's proceed. So here AC bar, mod of AC bar is equals to mod of DB bar. Okay, DB bar. So that will be equals to what we have is mod of what is AC bar? We have calculated is P bar plus Q bar. So mod of P bar plus Q bar, and it is equals to DB bar is nothing but P bar minus Q bar, mod of P bar minus Q bar. So to remove this modulus, we'll take the squares on both sides. So you will be having mod of P bar plus Q bar whole square, and this is equals to P bar minus Q bar whole square. Okay, now open the brackets. So P bar plus Q bar whole square is nothing but P bar plus Q bar into P bar, that is dot plus Q bar. It is equals to P bar minus Q bar dot P bar minus Q bar. Okay, so now open the bracket. So P bar dot P bar first plus p bar dot q bar plus q bar dot p bar plus q bar dot q bar, which is equals to p bar dot p bar minus p bar dot q bar minus q bar dot p bar minus minus plus q bar dot q bar. So what can be cancelled out? Same part we can definitely cancel out. See here, you can have this q bar on both sides, q bar dot p bar on both side, perfect. Then what we have is p q bar, p bar dot q bar and q bar dot p bar is the same. Commutative law is applicable, so we can have this p bar dot q bar plus p bar dot q bar, which is equals to here what you have is, if I take the negative sign common, so this will be equals to p bar dot q bar plus this is again the p bar dot q bar, commutative law. So this is nothing but 2 p bar dot q bar, and on this side also we have minus 2 p bar dot q bar. So implies what you can say is 2 p bar dot q bar plus 2 p bar dot q bar, so in total it becomes 4 p bar dot. Okay, so this is equals to 0. Let me write everything in detail. So this is nothing but the p 4 p bar dot q bar, it is equals to 0. So ye sab aisa hai, do not take 2 with p only. Okay, so you will mess it then. So this is the case. So 4 p bar dot q bar, so which becomes p bar dot q bar is equals to 0. Means what, sir? Dot product of p and q is 0. Means what? The p and q are what? Perpendicular. So p and q are perpendicular to each other. So this is the only we want to prove. So therefore p bar and q bar are parallel vectors. Therefore p bar and q bar are parallel, are perpendicular vectors, because their dot product is equals to 0. Therefore angle between p bar and q bar is 90 degree. Therefore it is a rectangle. Yes sir, perfect, very good. Okay, good. Okay, let's see the next question. So the question number is 10. Okay, so let me write the question number 10 here. Okay, show that the vector area of a quadrilateral, ABCD is 1 by 2 AC bar cross BD bar, where AC bar and BD bar are its diagonals. Okay, so this we have to show that. So let me draw a figure. See, कोई भी क्वेश्चन आए ना तो पहला काम करना है फिगर निकालना है. तो फिगर से ना बहुत सारे डाउट्स क्लियर हो जाते हैं. ओके, सो लेट्स हैव दिस क्वाड्रिलेटरल व्हिच इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. आल्सो वी कैन से पैरेललोग्राम इज अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. सो वी हैव ए बी सी डी, ए बी सी एंड डी. सो दिस इज अ ए सी बार and this is a BD bar. Okay, so AC bar and BD bar we have, these are the vectors. So what we have to show, that the area of this vector, area of this total quadrilateral is nothing but half of AC bar cross BD bar. Now if you focus very carefully, we have in this quadrilateral two triangles. So this total area of quadrilateral ABCD is equals to the area of a triangle, upper triangle and lower triangle, if you consider this AC bar. So area, vector area of a triangle ABC plus vector area of a triangle ACD, is this okay? So it is a triangle ACD. So this total means A half and A half. If I add these two triangles area, I will get the area of the quadrilateral. Okay. So let's check out the areas of individual triangles. So for area of triangle ABC, so what is that? We have already proved it. What is the area of a triangle? So while we were in the part of last section, so this is equals to, it is 1 by 2 AB bar cross AC bar. Okay, so AB bar cross AC bar, this is equals to AB bar cross AC bar, area of a triangle where AB and AC are the adjacent sides of your triangle, AB bar cross AC bar. So this is the equation number 1. Now let's find out this area of a triangle ACD. Area of a triangle ACD, so this is equals to 1 by 2 AC. See here, this AC and we have the AD bar, AC bar cross AD bar, AC bar, this vector AC bar and cross AD bar. Okay, this is the equation number 2. Now what to do? This equation number, let's say it is a star. So from equation number star 1 and 2, let's add all these. This is equals to, so area of quadrilateral ABCD is equals to 1 by 2. First area is what? It is a AB cross AC. So it is AB bar cross AC bar plus 1 by 2 AC bar cross AD bar. Okay. Now let's simplify this. Okay, see here, this is a cross AC bar and we have AC bar cross. So first let's make it same. So what is that? AB 1 by 2 into, I will make this as a AC bar cross AB bar. Okay, so if I do the commutative law in this cross product, then what happens? I should give the minus sign. So minus of AC bar cross AB bar plus 1 by 2 of AC bar cross AD bar. Okay. Now you see this AC bar cross is a common in both and 1 by 2 is also common. So let's take that. So it is 1 by 2 common if I take, and we take the AC bar common. So AC bar cross. So what is remaining is, in this we have this minus of AB bar and this is the AD bar. So minus of AB bar cross AD bar is the remaining. Okay. So what? You have this is 1 by 2 AC bar. What we have to prove? That it is equals to 1 by 2 AC bar cross BD bar. Now only the part is remaining was, this should be equals to BD bar. Now let's prove that AB bar and AD bar, AD bar plus. So we have already written that BD bar is equals to what? BD bar is equals to DA bar plus AB bar. Okay, DA bar plus AB bar, or you can go in other way, which is nothing but BD bar is equals to BA bar, BA bar plus AD bar. BA bar is nothing but minus of AB bar plus AD bar. Okay, so the same thing here we get. So this is nothing but minus of AB bar. Oh, sorry, it should be plus here, not cross. So minus of AB bar plus AD bar. So which is nothing but BD bar. Okay, so this is 1 by 2. See, 1 by 2 is common for everything. It is 1 by 2 into AC bar cross BD bar. I hope it is okay. Okay, so the only thing is what? We have to take some common part, that is AC bar cross. We have to take common. So for that, we have made some adjustment with the using the commutative law. Okay, so hence proved. So this is the area of a quadrilateral ABCD, which is equals to the cross product of both diagonals AC and BD. Half of the cross product of both diagonals. Perfect. Okay, so with this, let's start the next question. So question number 11, very simple question. Question number 11, it is the very famous one. Using vector method, we have to prove that. Using vector method, we have to prove that sine alpha plus beta, it is equals to sine alpha cos beta plus sine beta cos alpha. Okay, this is the very famous formula we have for sin A plus B. Sin A plus B, sin A, sin A, sin A cos B plus cos A, sin B. Okay, so for this, let's draw a figure here. So let's have the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis, y-axis, x-axis. Okay, let's have some vectors here. This is one vector and this is another vector. This vector is making an angle of beta with x-axis. This making an angle of minus alpha with x-axis. So let's take the points on these vectors. So let it is, this is a A point and this is a B point. Okay, and of course this is an origin. And let's prove. So please tell me, can you tell me what will be the coordinates of the point A and B? Coordinate system, we have seen that any point P, if it is lies in some space and suppose its magnitude is r from the origin and suppose this is making an angle of theta, okay, so what are the coordinates of this point P, which is nothing but r cos theta and r sin theta. We have seen that and we have already proved this in the second chapter. So P becomes r cos theta and r sin theta. Similarly here also, in this case we can have the coordinates of the point A and B, and we have selected these two points A and B such that the magnitude, that is OA and OB, are u1, that is mod of OA bar is equals to mod of OB bar, it is equals to 1. Okay, and those two are making an angle of minus alpha and beta respectively with the x-axis. So using the same concept, what I can write is this A point becomes what? It is r cos theta, r is 1, so this is 1 and this is also 1, so this is cos of minus alpha into sin of minus alpha, ye ho gaya mera A, and the B point becomes cos of beta into sin of, sorry, into ne comma sin of beta. So these are the two points of, so these are the two coordinates of the point A and B. So with the help of that, how we can prove? So what do you want here? You want sin alpha plus cos beta and sin beta plus cos alpha. Okay, so let's write down the vectors OA bar and OB bar with this help. So OA bar is equals to what? So this is A bar. Okay, so this is nothing but minus cos of alpha. Sorry, it's plus cos of alpha. Cos alpha. So minus cos theta is equals to, cos of minus theta is equals to cos theta, and sin of minus theta is equals to minus sin theta. Please remember that. So ye ho gaya apna cos of alpha only, and this becomes minus of sin of alpha. Okay. So OA bar will become cos alpha I minus sin alpha j plus 0 k. And what about OB bar? OB bar is equals to, so it is equals to cos beta and sin beta. So let's write down directly. It is cos beta I plus sin beta j plus 0 into k. Okay. Now I want the sin alpha plus beta. Okay. So means what? This whole angle I am asking. This whole angle. So for this, let's have the cross product of these two. OA bar and OB bar. So if I take the cross product, what you should get? So if I take the cross product of these two, I should get this vector, which is perpendicular to both A bar and B bar. Okay, so which is equals to y, and what is the direction vector of this is nothing but the k cap. Okay, so let's take OA bar and OB bar cross multiplication. So let's have this OA bar cross OB bar, and you know that how to do the cross multiplication, I, J and K. We have cos alpha minus sin alpha and 0, cos beta, sin beta and again 0. So this is equals to I into 0 minus J into 0 and plus K into, what you can have is cos alpha into sin beta minus minus plus sin alpha into cos beta. Okay, so this part is equals to, we have sin beta, or we'll write down like this, sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta into k. So this k is nothing but the unit vector. Okay, so this is OA bar cross OB bar. Now if I check the actual cross product, so ye to ho gaya cross product apna formula base. Okay, so what is actually OA bar and cross OB bar? That is, A bar cross B bar is actually what? It is mod of OA into mod of OB into sine of angle between them. What is the angle between OA and OB? Which is nothing but alpha plus beta. Okay, and into the direction vector, which is a k cap. So this is what we have. The angle between this OA and OB is nothing but alpha plus beta. This is the angle. This minus sign is what? It is just because of we are considering in the negative direction. That's why. Okay, so the angle between is what? It is alpha plus beta. So from this, what we can say, and mod OA mod OB is nothing but what? It is 1 1. So we have sine alpha plus beta into k cap. So this is equation number 1 and it is equation number 2, and these both are the same, which is OA bar cross OB bar. And if I compare these two equations, so what you will get? OA bar, so from equation from 1 and 2, what you will get is sine of alpha plus beta k cap, it is equals to sine alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta into k cap, which is nothing but the k cap one. So we can directly cancel out these two vectors, k cap and k cap, because of the same vectors. Hence proved, this is the only we want to prove, that is sin alpha. Therefore hence proved, that is a sin alpha plus beta, it is equals to sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha and sin beta. This is the only thing we want to prove that. Okay, that's it. It's very very simple. Okay, just need some patience. Okay, let's see the last question. So question number 12, what it is? The question number 12 goes like this. Prove that in an isosceles triangle, the median passing through the vertex, vertex common to the equal sides of a triangle, is perpendicular to base. Okay, so please go through this statement, and if you have not understood, what is the first step we need to do is draw the triangle, isosceles triangle. So let me have the isosceles triangle here for you. Oops, very good, perfect. So we have this isosceles triangle here, and let's have the median then. So let me draw with some green color here. So median we have, so this is what, these two sides are same, equal. So let's name this as A, B and C, isosceles triangle. The vertex common to the equal sides, which is A, perpendicular to base bola. So the median drawn from this point is perpendicular to the base. So this is what we have to show, that is AD bar dot BC bar should be equals to 0. We have to prove this. Okay, so for that purpose, let's make use of the given information. So what are the information they have given is, in the isosceles triangle you have, okay, so before that, let's assume the vectors here. So let's name this as a vector A bar. Okay, let me change the color here. So red, so it's an A bar, it's a C bar, and let's name this as a D bar. Okay, so these are the position vectors of point B, D, C with respect to A. okay. So let AB bar is equals to A bar, AD bar is equals to D bar, and AC bar is equals to C bar. Okay, the position vectors of point BDC with respect to A. What you have to show that this, the AD bar dot BC bar is equals to 0. Again, one more thing, given is what? It is mod of A, it is equals to mod of C. So the vector A and C are same because of the isosceles triangle. Now let's take the dot product of AD and BC. So AD bar dot BC bar is equals to, what is AD bar? Is nothing but D bar dot C, BC bar is nothing but C bar minus B bar. Okay. And D is the midpoint of point B and C. So what we can have is B bar plus C bar by 2 dot C bar minus B bar, which is equals to 1 by 2. I have taken 1 by 2 outside. So it is B bar dot B bar plus C bar dot C bar minus B bar. So let's simplify this, open the bracket. So you will be having B bar dot C bar minus B bar plus C bar and minus C bar dot B bar. This is equal. Now from this, what can be cancelled out? See, BC and this CB can be cancelled out. Commutative law hai, dono same rahega dot product mein. So BC and CB are same with a negative sign. So we have finally the remaining with minus B square plus C square. Okay, and you know that the given information is what? It is B and C are same. Okay, sorry. So this is what we have to consider as a B, not A. Okay, so this is a B. This is the B. Sorry. So this should be a B. Okay. So that is what the position vector of point B. Now it should be B only, not A. Okay. So then what we have? B is equals to C. So the given is B is equals to C. So here we go. So 1 by 2. As B square and B and C are same, so B square minus A square is equals to 0. So that their dot product is equals to 0. Means what? AD bar dot BC bar is equals to 0. AD bar dot BC bar is equals to 0. Implies AD bar is perpendicular to BC bar. This is the only thing we want to prove here in this question. That's it for this exercise. So I hope you get everything here. Please do more practice. Again, you try to solve all these questions on your own. Just looking at these videos will not definitely help you. So it's a request, all of you, please, you do these exercises parallelly with me while you are watching this video. Okay, so in the next class we will be dealing with the miscellaneous question. Each and every question again we'll be dealing. So be in touch. So we'll stop here. Thank you so much.